Shalom, shalom. Out here once again, get started right away. Started healing. All right, get in the spirit. Get up in the scriptures right away. So you want to seem to be one of the quiet before the storm moments. That's what it feels like. Anyway, first and foremost, like the Lord, praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bashem, Rakakadash. Okay, double honors to our apostles of Great Millstone. That's our elders of GMS. Pay a salutation, peace, and blessings to the hopeful elect of the children of Israel that are the 12 tribes, that are children of Israel, through the scriptures, all through the scriptures is speaking to. Okay? That's the people of Negro and Indian Latino descent. Okay, and more specifically, it's the elect of those people who the Lord is referring to. Because really, in all reality, they're the only ones that's crying to the Lord, they're the only ones listening to the Lord, they're the only ones calling to the Lord and watching for the Lord. You know, and not being those part of that nation of hypocrites. You know, a nation of hypocrites who the Most High is going to literally destroy because they don't want to wash their hands of their iniquities. They want to continue on this bullshit. All right. So again, some peace and salutation to the whole four elect. All right, and Israelite foreigners who the help us in our side of the spirit across the four corners of the earth who are Israelites. All right. Scattered amongst the four corners of the earth, meaning those Israelites that are living amongst those other nations. You know, they are being judged like that they're part of those nations. But really, if they have the spirit, they're of an Israelite, that's what they are. So you can't be judging things like the scripture said, judge not according to the outwardly appearance. And that's an actual commandment, man. Judge not. Judge not the outward appearance of men. And that's what these niggas is doing, is going on. That's why we always say, man, it's important. Your teachers is important, man. Whoever Yahweh Shai sent to you in truth. That's why it's important who your teachers are, you know? And yes, you gotta have teachers in this thing, man. You know, and there's an account where Israelite foreigner was being confronted with something. He said, well, how can I know this? Because I was teaching the background to just get the scriptures and I'm like, but in the meantime, you got two-thirds that are just gonna make up shit as they go. And pretty much those are wines that those are the drunken the two-thirds, that's just the drunkenness that they carry upon themselves, that burden of drunkenness, man. That burden of drunkenness, that drunkenness is with many minds, that's philosophies and madness, man. Like I said, Jake loved that shit, man. And Jake, like I said, preferred to make it up on his own. Rather just somebody tell him something without him going into it and researching. You know? And pretty much Jake just don't give a damn, period. He just, with his own, his, you know, he has his daddy spirit. Esau, that spirit of Esau, you know? His daddy, the damn devil. So what would I quote? Scripture I quote, it's like, let me get some, quote some of these things here. This shit is going to come down the pipe. And it's coming down the pipe real quick. Slockiness. I forgot the spirit. The scripture that I was actually going to get, you know. Yeah. I got another one. Pretty much referring to what I'm referring to, but pretty much support what I'm referring to. Let me jump right to it. Find it first. Drunk and running on. Be sober. Here, let me look that up. Let me look that up. Be sober. 1 Peter 5:8. Be sober. Be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, is a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. And that's how can you the eyes have that eye solved to be able to spot a devil, you know, And devils, these devils, man, like they say, come in many different forms and shapes and colors, man. You know? You gotta understand, there's devils that look just like us, man. There's devils walking around. You got these black conscious goddamn idiots talking about melanin. I mean, there's beauty in it, but at the same time, that melanin itself is not a free pass into the kingdom. That melanin isn't a badge of honor as far as, I'm part of the elect. That melon, man, you know, wrong, you know? And that's what these niggas is pushing, this melanin family, man. Melanin ain't got shit to do with it. Though it is a beautiful badge, a beautiful thing, they ain't got shit to do with it, you know? They ain't got shit to do with assisting us in getting to the kingdom of motherfucking heaven, man. It's like, I don't mean that, but they don't have no bearings on us, any of the elect making it to the kingdom of heaven, man. Because there's brethren, sisters as well, man, that's probably lepers as hell without this deep melody, man. That's part of the elect. You gotta remember, he's gonna gather his people from the four corners of the earth, man. You know? Shit, this get back amongst all the nations. You know? If not of the 144,000, but of the great multitude that that second Ezra's, I'm not sure if it's 13 goes into, that multitude, great multitude that second Ezra 13 may go into. Revelation 7 may go into, but since I mentioned it, you see, these niggas got people drunk on all these different, on this bullshit, on these different madman philosophies, man. Fucking Yaku and shit. Them same niggas that's pushing that's like the Nation of Islam, but that shit done branched off from the Nation of Islam. Now that Yaku shit is part of the black conscious community, man. You know? But that great multitude, how do you explain that? Well, you can't explain it. Because y'all don't know about it. Y'all don't have the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding to hand this standard to explain them any damn thing, man. You know? You're condemning yourself because you're wicked. So again, after the whole vision of Ezra's having of the Lord coming and destroying all the armies of the earth, man, that was fighting the great war, you know, I'm just gonna fast forward ahead. Verse 11, this is 2nd Ezra 13 and 11, and they were all mixed together, sloppy. I'm gonna start a tour. Afterwards, I saw the same man come down from the mountain. That mountain was a chariot. It was a UFO, the world ignorantly calls it UFO. And call unto him another peaceable multitude. Another peaceable, because we're naturally a peaceful people, man. You know? It's just two-thirds right now that are out of their goddamn minds. Or out of their wicked-ass minds, man. You know? These bloodthirsty-ass Israelites, man. Bloodthirsty-ass Jakes. I don't even want to call them Israelites. Bloodthirsty Jakes, man. A peaceful multitude, and there came much people unto him, whereof some were glad, some were sorry, some of them were bound, and others some brought of them that were offered. Then was I sick with great fear, and I went, there you go. That was that great multitude, a great multitude. It wasn't just the governing elect, you know, is a great multitude coming from the four corners of the earth, you know. That's a beautiful thing. Revelation 7. Revelation 7. I'm going to get to some of these prophecies. I'm not going to be stuck there. Sober, man. You gotta learn how to, you gotta have a built-in spiritual cipher within you, man. If that's what I'm referring to, a cipher, that can sift out the bullshit. and keep that which is needed, you know? The truth, you know? And a lot of all these other things that are going down, like distractions and a whole lot of other things that are going down, like this devil is passing legislation for this, for that. For example, like the main thing that's coming together is that central bank digital currency thing, which you already know, everything is headed toward the Quran, man, the mark of the beast. All right, and actually the whole system combined is headed toward that. So right now this devil is making moves as far as the financial part goes. All right, he's making moves as far as the military part goes. He's making moves as well, dealing with the social behavior of people, blocking out the truth and bringing in all kind of falsehood, the control mechanism part of this whole thing. He's bringing all this shit together into one. That's part of his new world. So you can't be stuck on. You gotta realize what's going down, today, man. This ain't no time to be partying. Like that's a big thing now. Everybody got these niggas got that feminine spirit on them. Always wanting to have fun, man. Have pleasure. And that's the dude used to say to us in campus in high school. Listen. What was his name? Lizard. I can't remember his name. I ain't seen him in so long. But we used to call him Lizard. We had a couple of nicknames for him. Leonard. That was his name, Leonard. And Leonard goes, oh, his name, why don't y'all just go have fun, man? And that was years ago, man. Years ago. 2011, 2012, 13. Years ago, man. Well, why don't y'all just go have fun, man? Y'all need to just have fun and enjoy life, man. That's the spirit of the woman. What the scripture say about these weak women? She that liveth in pleasure is dead while she liveth. You know, these whores, women, they're dead while they living, not even knowing that they gonna be caught up out here. Man. You gotta understand, the mass majority of these people, these men and women, man, they gonna get caught up out here. Not knowing what was going down. You just can't wait to the last moment and think you know what's going down. And that's what a lot of these motherfuckers do. Especially when confronted with the truth. They act like they know what you're saying, but have no fucking clue what you're saying. And really, a lot of times, especially when it's referring to oppression and your enemy, they agree with it, but they don't understand what's going down, man. Because if they did, they'd be out here preparing for it. If you listen to you talk, but they nodding their hand. You nod their head like they agree with you, but if they agree, then like I said, they will be doing the works of someone that agree. They will have the behavior of someone that agree, but most of them don't. You know, there's more far more to this truth. It is a truth. There's far more to the truth than, yeah, we were enslaved. Yes, the oppressor is still oppressing the hell out of us. There's far more to it than that, man. You know, part of the truth is waking up. And not just waking up, waking up and following the Lord, man. That's his word. You know, not just waking up to certain facts. Yeah, the devil's still in charge. Yeah, the devil is still killing our people. Yeah, of course he is. Yeah, the devil's always been stealing money, stealing land. Yeah, we know that. But there's far more to it than that, right? You know? So like the scripture says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary the devil. Your adversary, Satan. I think that's what actually Satan means. Satan means adversary. Your adversary. Your enemy, pretty much. It says here, adversary, opponent. Enemy. There you go. So the scripture says that your adversary, the devil, the enemy, your enemy, the devil. As a roaring lion walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. You see? And look on that goddamn 2012 thing, man. Look at how many of y'all got devoured. Now a lot of y'all are just physically destroyed because of that 2020 thing. A lot of you fell into the trap of the devil, man. Not knowing what's going on. If you've been listening to the prophets, said, man, don't be doing that. Don't go line up for that thing, man. Don't go sipping on that dirty ass cup of shit that devil's offering you, man. And now look at you, a lot of you motherfuckers is dropping dead now. A lot of you are sick and worried. Blood pressure high as hell, stressed the hell out because you know something's wrong with you. You know? I'm not getting no response because I'm out of curiosity. Oh, bro, I had to stop dealing with it, man. She went to line up and got three of them goddamn things. I think she's dead. She's not responding to nothing. Nothing at all. She would quit. She was one of them quick responding, like that. She told me, ever since I drank that Kool-Aid, I ain't never felt the same again. Well, why'd you line up for the second one? Why'd you line up for the fucking third one, dumbass? You know, because everybody was so anxious to get out there and get back to fucking normal, enjoy themselves, and have fun. Like the scripture says. Like the scripture says. Here. Is dead while she lives. It's going like, what's up, man? First Timothy 5:1, you are not an elder and treat him as a father and the younger man as brother. The elder woman as mothers, the younger as sisters, with all purity. Out of widows that are widows indeed, but if any widow have children, remember that they learn first to show piety at home and to requite their parents, for that is good and acceptable for the Most High. Now she that is a widow, indeed, and desolate, trusted in the Most High, and continue for supplication and prayer night and day. That's, you know how rare that is, that actual woman that he's describing, which is, again, is rare now, you know? Because the state of these women now is, that's a great example of the great generation of the former great gods. Majority of those that's getting out of here, man, are women. And I ain't talking about America, I'm talking about around the four corners of the earth, man. That multitude is going to be mainly women, you know? Because in the kingdom, man, you know how much the outside wants us to have many, many wives. Another topic there. But she that lived in the pleasure dead while she lived in. These things give in charge that they may be blameless. You know? So we come out here so you give you keys of how to wash your hands of the blood, wash the blood from your hands so you can be blameless. We're constantly pushing repentance. Constantly pushing repentance. But these women are off. They're on full rebellion mode, as high as it can get, man. They now are in full rebellious mode, man. That is to the point that now they are, like the scripture says, the Most High has created a new thing on the earth, the woman shall surpass a man. You know? There ain't no correcting when the scriptures is given for correction and rebuke. Ain't no correcting them now. They want to do their own motherfucking thing. So now you see them walk around naked damn near, pussies out. You know? You can literally see, and that's a hot thing that's going on. That woman probably don't still don't. She's probably hearing all the criticism, and she probably don't feel no shame, you know? Hell, Esau probably sent that bitch a check, man, so to comfort her tears. Or sent her a check so the tears won't start flowing so that she will sit back and rethink her actions, man. Their actions, because there was more than one. I don't know why the video when the bitch was getting into her car, we walked to her car, and turned getting to her car, pussy all out, sitting in the car, shit is all open. That's out in the open too. That's for the public too, you know? The shameless woman shall be counted as a dog. And my point is just these men have the same spirit that these bitches out on, man. They on full rebellion. In full rebellion, man. But if any provide not for his own, and especially for those of his own house, he hath denied the faith, and is worse than an infidel. Let not a widow be taken into the number under 3 score years old, having been the wife of one man, well reported of for good works, that she hath brought up children, that she hath lodged strangers, that she hath washed the saints' feet, that she hath relieved the afflicted, that she hath diligently followed every good work. But the younger widow refused. But when they have begun to wax wanton against the Messiah, they will marry, having damnation, because they have cast off their first faith. And whether they learn to be idle, wandering about from house to house, and not only idle, but tattlers also, and busybodies, speaking things which they ought not. And that's a full blast. They are on the goddamn, what you want to call, podcast, and whatever the hell you want to call podcast, speaking about why, how men supposed to treat them and what they want and what they demand from men. And you hear from actual specialists that deal with women and their problems are quit dealing with them, right? Are no longer giving women advice, man, because these women are delusional. Their expectations are impossible to me, because really, that you can never, these women are never pleased, man. They never motherfucking happy with what they want. You know, they may be happy at that moment, but tomorrow is gonna be a whole different emotion in that, in the mix. And that's how they are, man. These people are, these women are emotional wrecks, man. These women are emotional wrecks. A child, they're nothing but on a child's level, period. What did the psychiatrist say? Didn't the psychiatrist say these women don't really mature no more than a 14-year-old? A 14-year-old? I'm not sure if it's 12, 13, or 12 or 14 years old. They say they don't mature, you know? But they hold it over there in your head, oh, I can pay my bills. Goddamn it, good. You're supposed to pay your goddamn bills. If you're working, you got your idiot. Idiot. Hey, if you got a job, you should be able to pay your bills. You know? But they have impossible, unheard of expectations. You know? Want a real man when they don't even know what a real man is or a real woman is, you know? So anyway. So they're having these podcasts speaking madness, man. And in every podcast, men are destroying them with common sense, pretty much. Let me just say that, because these niggas, all they doing is using common sense in male and female relationship. But other than that, them niggas, these motherfuckers are cutting through them. They ain't got the truth either. They don't have no wisdom, knowledge, and understanding either, you know? While they sitting back getting paid on these podcasts, them motherfuckers ain't no wisdom, these niggas that are cutting, they ain't no examples of no wise men. We're not, like I said, all they're doing is just using common sense to deal with these foolish women. They ain't no good example of men in themselves, you know? The only real examples of men to follow, the only examples of men to follow is Greg Millstone. Period. Of course, you gotta talk the talk, you gotta walk the walk. You gotta across the full spectrum. So again, speaking things which they ought not. I was therefore that the younger woman married too, so you know, these hoes just doing their own goddamn thing. So how you gonna know any of this if you're not walking around sober, man? You gonna fall like you gonna like this the fucking same goddamn idiot said to me. To each his own. What? That's an individual void of understanding that even uses that. That term, to each his own. Nope, that's the same as do as thou will, the same spirit. Do as thou will, to each his own. It's the same shit. Now, these motherfuckers, again, just in the spirit of pleasing the flesh, man. Feeling good. They're always in the spirit of feeling good. So in their debauchery, their drugs involved, Lawrence large consumptions of alcohol is involved, different wild forms of sexual behavior. No morals, man. Just a moralist people, man. You know? Your soul will be different because you're African and you're walking. The Lord God walks without sickness and you may be bothered. So if you're not sober, if you're taking on, if you're living in that same fucking state of mind as everybody else, man, the majority of the people, man, you're going, again, you're going to get caught up out there with those fools, man. You know? Whom resist the steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same affliction will accomplish in your brethren that are in the world. But the Most High of all grace, who has called us unto his eternal glory by Yahweh Shai and Mashiach, as it that we have suffered the while, make you perfect, established, strengthened, and settled. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Okay, let me find another one here. I was on one of those ones was referring to the addition of God. Search the internet, I want to watch and look, you know, like we normally do. Internet fucking up all week long. Shit pisses you the hell off. I mean, and you try not to use an excuse to get out and just be lazy, but you got to continue on the spirit, you got to continue on this fight all fucking week long and the internet fucking up. For no fucking reason. Just fucking up. Pages won't load. Just fucking up. That's the devil, man. That's these devils, man. That's frustrating, that though. It's frustrating, but you put, just keep praying, and you just keep on. You just keep grinding at it. You know? Isaiah 5:22 says, woe unto them that are wise in their own eyes and prudent in their own sight. Woe unto them that are mighty to drink wine and men of strength to kneel a strong drink, which justify the wicked for reward and take away the righteousness of the righteous from him. Therefore, as the fire devours the stubble and the flame consumeth the chaff, so their roots shall be rottenness, and their blossoms shall go up as dust, because they have cast away the law of the Lord of hosts, and despised the word of the Holy One of Israel. Therefore is his anger the Lord kindled against his people, and he has stretched forth his hand against them, and has smitten them, and the hills did tremble, and their carcasses were torn in the midst. When the streets for all this, his anger is turned away, he's not turned away, but his hand is stretched out to speak. And he will lift up his ensign to the nations from afar, and will hiss unto them from the ends of the earth, and cold, and shall come and speed swiftly. None shall be worried nor stumble among them. None shall slumber nor sleep. Neither shall the girdle of their loins be loosed, nor the latchet of their shoes be broken. Whose arrows are sharp, and all their bones, and their horses' hooves shall be counted like sand, and their bulls like a whirlwind. Their roaring shall be as a lion. This is instruction. They shall roar like young lions. Yea, they shall roar and lay hold of the prey, and shall carry it with safety. And none shall deliver. And in that day shall roar against them like the roaring of the sea. And if one look into the land, and call darkness and sorrow, light is darkness and death is dark. go on to Isaiah 21, go on to the crowd, the problem, to the trumpets, the beast, these glorious beings, this inflated power, which are in the head of the fat bodies of them that are overcome with water. To Isaiah 28:7. This is a real good one here. But they also have erred through wine, and through strong drink are out of the way. The priest and the prophet have erred through strong drink, and these are all referring to their beliefs, man, their belief systems, all these false philosophies. You know? They're all swallowed under wine, they are out of the way to strong drink. They err in division, but stumble in judgment. What's it like? What's that? Ephraim is referring to the Roman king. Isaiah 22. Starting one, go to the crowd. To the drunkards of Ephraim, whose glorious beauty is a fitting fire like a red flame. Behold, the Lord hath a mighty and strong wind, which has a tempest of hail and a strong storm, as a flood of mighty waters overflowing shall cast down to the earth with the hand. The crown of pride, the drunkards of Ephraim shall be trodden under feet, and the glory whose beauty, which is on the head of the fat valley shall be as a fading fire and as hasty fruit before the sun, which when he hath looked upon it seeth while it is yet in his hand, he eateth it up. And that day shall the Lord of hosts before a crown of glory, and for a diadem of beauty unto the rescue of his people, and for a spirit of judgment to him that sitteth in judgment, and for strength to them that turn the battle to the gate. And they have erred through wine. Listen, they also have buried through wine and through strong drink. And through strong drink are out of the way. Not in the truth. Not, you know, not on the right path. Not on the straight path, man. The priests and the prophets have buried through strong drink. They have swallowed up through the wine. They are out of the way through strong drink. They are invisible. They stumble in judgment. And the vision. What's the vision? Of prosperity, which is getting old now. And these churches, eventually, the church is going to fall apart as well, man. Those temples made with hands, man. Eventually, the Most High is going to tear those, he's going to scatter those people as well. Man. Because that prosperity gospel is getting fucking old now. You know? It's getting old now. That gospel is to cater to these goddamn women. It's getting old now, man. You know? Because like the Lord said, he's going to make a man more precious than fine gold. And you're going to find out in these churches, man, that these women are going to be fucking. Whoever in these goddamn churches, they're going to be lost, man. And they're going to be out there in confusion. Not knowing what the hell is going on. You know? Because they're going to find out that man that's been teaching them is a false prophet. Man. And the Lord's not even dealing with them, period. You know? So they err in vision. They stumble in judgment, meaning they're not judging correctly or uprightly. They support these women in their feminist movement. As long as they can fill that motherfucking that offering plate, they gonna tell it how it is, man. How they gonna tell it how it is? That's gonna affect their cheddar. You know? For all tables are full of vomit and filthiness, so that there is no place clean. Whom shall he teach knowledge? And whom shall he make to understand doctrine? Then are weaned from the milk, and he's referring to humble individuals. You know? Because a child is weaned from the milk. And draw from the breast. That's a baby, that's an infant. That's what he's referring to. He's going to wake it up and give us knowledge and understanding to a humble individual. You know? And I'm telling you now, you're full of all what? You're You drunk with all those, with all that wine, man. You gonna, man, you can't, these motherfuckers ain't gonna humble themselves, man. And these proud ass hoes, man, that are getting all kind of benefits that the Lord's about to take away. You know? Isaiah 3 is about to take all that shit away. These proud ass hoes, man. Hey, look. Actually, you can see the nightmare scenario. You can see how it's gonna play out, and you can see it's actually coming, but these people, man, they're literally walking out here just blind. Literally just walking blind. You can't teach them nothing. Pride, their whole body is compassed about with pride, man. So there ain't no teaching them, man. For precept must be from precept, Chapter 27 and 24. I have hated many things, but nothing like him, for the Lord will hate me. Whoso casteth a stone will hide casteth it on his own head, and the deceitful stroke shall make wounds. Whoso diggeth a pit shall fall therein, and he that setteth a trap shall be taken therein. He that worketh mischief, it shall fall upon him, and he shall not know whence they come. Mockery and reproach are from the proud, but vengeance as a lion shall lie in wait for them. They that rejoice at the fall of the righteous shall be taken in the snare, and anguish shall consume them before they die. Malice and wrath, even these are abominations, and the sinful man shall have them both. Hey. We're blowing the trumpet, man. You know? What's the scripture again? It's like Ezekiel said, go to my people and give them warning from me. You know? But again, they ain't trying to hear it, man. That's the last thing they're trying to hear. Because they're drunken with all that wine. You know? All that madness they prefer. So in order to see these things happen, man, you gotta be sober. It's as simple as that. You just simply got to be sober. 1 Thessalonians 5 says, therefore let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. Here, look at this. Let me go to the chapter. For they that sleep in the night, and they that be drunken are drunken in the night. But let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet, the hope of salvation. For the Most High hath not appointed us to wrath, but to obtain salvation by our Lord Yahushua HaMashiach. He died for us. He didn't die for everybody. He died for the elect. Whether we wait or soon, we should live together with him. Wherefore, comfort yourselves together and edify one another, even as also ye do. This is beautiful. And we beseech you, brethren, to know them which labor among you, to know them and are over you in the Lord, and admonish you, and to esteem them very high in love for their sake, work sake, and be at peace among yourselves. Now we exhort you, brethren, warn them that are unruly, comfort the feeble mind, support the weak, and patient toward all men. All right, so warning them that are unruly, either they're not trying to hear, or they're going to come up against it, period. You know? Their ears are uncircumcised. See that none further keep us from evil unto evil man, but ever follow that which is good, both among yourselves and to all men. Rejoice evermore, pray without ceasing. Everyone give thanks, for this is the will of the Most High and the Messiah and our side concerning you. Quench not the spirit, despise not the prophesying. Prove all things, or fast that which is good. Abstain from all appearance of evil. In the very good, in the very power of peace, sanctify you holy. And I pray the Most High, the Holy Spirit, and so in body, so blameless, to the coming of our Lord Yahushua HaMashiach. They can't hear this. This is our instruction. They can't hear this. So they, again, continue on who they are. Faithful is he that holds, who also will do it. You see that faithful is he that calleth you. He ain't a liar, man. So he said he's going to deliver his elect. That's exactly what he's going to do. Brethren, pray for us. Greet all the brethren with a holy kiss. I charge you by the Lord power that this epistle be read unto all the holy brethren. The grace of our Lord power, the power shall be Messiah, be with you tonight. Go back to your bodies. Isaiah 51:21. Therefore hear now this, thou afflicted and drunken and not with wine. What's that referring to? It's referring to wisdom. It's referring to the philosophies. And not with wine. Thus said the Lord power. Thus said thy Lord, the Lord our power, and thy power that keepeth the course of this people. Behold, I have taken out of thy hand a cup of trembling. Even dredge of the cup of my fury, thou shalt no more drink of it again. But I will put it into the hand of them that afflict thee, which have said to thy soul, bow down, that we may go over it, and thou hast made my body as a ground, and as a street to them that went over. Alright? So no more. So the elect is waking up. He's waking our eyes up to the devil. Let's say this one, his mission that this government's going to be here, which is bringing in his new world order, you know? And this is just coming in many different forms, man. Like right here, I got, again, I gave you examples how this devil he's going to bring the whole thing together. It's just not all working together right now, but it's all working together. me, like I said, the financial part of this thing, the social part of this thing, which is like criminal record, your medical records, passing again. Again, he's passed his laws to police the internet of truth. So eventually all this is, I know I'm leaving something out, but all this will eventually come together. Oh, you know what? If you even know of this, here, let me block something. I'm going to read that 23 moments about this in Revelation 7. That's okay. I don't need to. If you haven't already, read this here. It's called the Lucis Trust. Lucis Trust. And there are 10 rules that they're bringing in. That there's 10 rules that they have to apply to help bring in that new world order. And here, let me read some of those. This is crazy, man. And the Lucis Trust is this bitch that came up with this. And the funny thing is, the UN has adopted these plans. All right, so I thought I had it downloaded on my PDF files. Let me see if I have it. I know I did. Documents. Here we go. I keep all this stuff, man. A lot of these things you have to download because the internet's not always going to be around. The internet and actual power period, so it's good to have actual books, physical books, man. But if they shut down the internet because you know they're policing the truth, it's good to have these things downloaded on your files. You have to start doing these things once again. The day is coming where we're going to have to rely on the wisdom, knowledge, and understand. Like the scripture said, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of our night times, man. This information that we gather, we don't dump it and throw it all away. We take notes and we put that stuff up. Buying books, ordering books, we keep these things. Bibles, that's crazy. Bibles, apocryphs, and so on. Dictionaries, literature, exonerated dictionary. A lot of this stuff we're bringing out to the world, revealing a lot of these things, information that we use to help us destroy these strongholds. So anyway, the 10-point plan of the New World Order, which is literally adopted by the United Nations. And you know they're not United Nations, it's all Esau shit. It says the 10-point plan of the New World Order, or how to prepare the way of the Antichrist. And you already know that there ain't just one Antichrist. Their Antichrist, they're referring to is actually the spirit of Satan. Satanism. Because there's many anti-Yahushites. There's many anti-Messiahs, or the anti-Mashiachs, okay? The strategy, the 10-point charter of Alex Bailey. You gotta take notes of this, break this down. Adopted by the UN. You know, to adopt something. Here, let's do this. This is a trip, man. It's getting worse and worse. You can't miss certain things, you just can't even. What's the point? They ain't missing to these niggas in the world now. They ain't trying to hear it. They just simply don't want to hear it. So the Most High is going to have to do something to make them hear it. Just like he did in 2020. He shut the whole fucking world down. Everybody had to rely on the internet. And what was on the internet? The truth. Facts and truth was plummeting the internet. So this devil had to open shit right back up again and get these people back outside. Man. You know, we gotta get these people back outside. We gotta give them their marijuana, we gotta give them alcohol, we gotta give them their pleasure. We gotta, and that's what bread and circus has kicked it up into another gear as well. That bread and circus shit, same shit that they use in the Roman Empire. Bread and circus, man. got the people out here just having fucking fun, looking for the next fucking goddamn vacation, man. Here all hell is about to break fucking loose, and these people are looking to go on a goddamn vacation, cruises. Are you out of your mind when going to cruise as unstable as this world, as this planet is? You seeing videos going up on these motherfuckers going on cruises, man, and them massive-ass ships is getting rocked to and fro, being flooded with seawater, man. You gotta be out of your goddamn mind on that ship that's, they got sharks that's following these cruise ships, man. You gotta be out your goddamn mind on this ship that's going down, going to airplane flights, just to have fun, man. Just to keep your ass in that soft mentality, that feminine, female mentality. You lost your goddamn mind. Adoption. The action or fact of legally taking another child and bringing him up as one's own. And in this case, the 10-point plan, or the fact of being adopted. The action or fact of choosing to take up, follow, or use something. Okay? Let me read that number two again. The action or fact of choosing to take up, follow, or use something. So let me get back to this again. It says here, the strategy, the 10-point charter of Alice Bailey, adopted by the United Nations. The purpose, to change Judeo-Christian tradition, or to redeem the nation from Judeo-Christian tradition, which in this case is the Hebrew Israelite tradition, you know? Because right now we're pushing that righteousness has to come back into this world, you know? Which we're preaching life to these people, man. And that's anti this devil, you know? The doctrine of truth, the doctrine of the Kabbalah and Messiah is anti this devil. You know, so he's doing everything he can to put down the power. And this devil's been working day and night for years and years. He ain't just started this. He's been working for hundreds of years, man, to get to this very point that we're in now. He's been to their Christians, actually, Hebrew Israelite Christians, cousins, Hebrew Israelite cousins, man. But like the scripture says, seek out the old path, the ways of the ancient. You know, order. We have order upon some people. Periods would get going off. Periods on people would go off. The Bible is specific in that too. Examples on people getting right and saved by the Lord, and then going off again. You know, this is the last motherfucking time, man. This is it. This is the last time. So let me get into reading some of these here. Number one, take the Most High in prayer out of the education system. She said, change curriculum to ensure that the children are free from the bondage of Christian culture. Why? Because children go to school to be equipped to face life. They are willing to trust and they are willing to value what has been given to them. You see how those that are weaned from the milk and drawn from the breast, you see, that's a humbling child. A child you can teach. Brother, you are. If you're a devil, man, you can teach that child to be an even bigger devil than you. But if you're a righteous man, you can teach that child to be an even a righteous man. You know, teach a child, man. You know, so they can grow up and continue on. So you're attacking the children. If you take those out of education unconsciously. And they already knew this, man. This devil's a master of psychology. Because he studies psychology. Especially our people, our emotional-ass people. If you take the Most High out of education, it will unconsciously form and resolve that the Most High is not necessary to face life. It's like they will unconsciously form and resolve that the Most High is not necessary to face life. They will focus on those things the school counseling word to be passed on, and they will look at the Most High as additional, if one can afford the additional. See what I'm saying? These devils are true devils, man. Thank you, sir. So just give me a scripture. This applies to Mr. and Mrs. Esau. Mr. and Mrs. Esau, all right? Hebrews 12 and 16 says, there be any foreign or profane person as Esau, who for one morsel of meat sold his birthright. For he know how that afterward, when he would have inherited the blessing, he was rejected. But he found no place of repentance, though he sought it carefully with tears. So it's telling you there that this devil, Mr. and Mrs. Devil, man, these are the same people that are supposed to have your best interest, your welfare in being part, you know? And this is Mrs. Esau that's come up with this 10-point plan. Now, this devil, man, a damn devil, man, take the most high prayer out of the education system. Rebuke parental authority. Over the children? What kind of mindedness is that? She said, break the communications between parent and child? This speaks for itself, man. Why it asks? So that the parent do not pass on their Christian tradition to their children. Liberate children from the bondage of their parents' tradition. Hold up. Gotta get the scriptures. You can't make this shit up, man. You can't make this shit up, man. Son calls him to often to feel the rod, that he may have joy of him in the end. He that chastens his son shall have joy in him, and shall rejoice of him among his acquaintances. He that teacheth his son grieveth the enemy, and before his friends he shall rejoice of him. So this devil is working overtime. He's working overtime, man. You know? So it was important that this goes into full effect. You know? It definitely shit, man. Let's see if I can find another scripture. Rob not the poor, because he was poor, you go first, or simply the poor. flock, I reckon wrong, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. So this devil, who knows what's going on with us, man? You know? He knows we teach our good will, you know, whether they obtain them or not, whether they're practicing or not. He knows the message that we give. We give this message to our children, man, the boys in the game, man. You know, to turn from this world, man. And so whether they do it or not, hey, that's up to the Lord, you know what I'm saying? But if it weren't for this devil, man, our children would have been, they would be leaning more to our side. They would be leaning more to the Lord, you know what I'm saying? So this is something that just started. This has been works for years, man. This has been in works for years. Check this out. Promote excessive child rights. Abolish corporal punishment. This has been made law. On the other hand, the Bible says, do not withhold correction from a child. For if you beat him with a rod, he will not die. You shall beat him with a rod and deliver his soul from hell. So it says, to the point now you have kids calling cops on their parents. And literally getting the parents locked up, the child end up in a home that being among strangers that eventually end up raping them or killing them. Or not that, forcing their bullshit on them and got them raised and got them making decisions on into changing their sex and mutilate themselves. You know? Hey, this is why we need a savior, man. This. Number three, destroy the Judeo-Christian family structure or the traditional Christian family structure. She said it is oppressive and that the family is the core of the nation. If you break the family, you break the nation. Liberate the people from the confines of this structure. Promote sexual promiscuity. Free young people to the concept of premarital sex. Now, by the time she's 14 years old, she's on the hook. In a lot of cases, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, these women are already packed up double-digit bodies. When she would have been with just that one man, sex lifted so high that the joy of enjoying it, sex is the highest joy in life. Fantasizing that everybody will feel proud to be seen to be sexually active, even those outside of marriage. This is crazy, man. This is absolutely mind-boggling. It says, if sex is free, then make abortion legal and make it easy. She said build clinics for abortions, health clinics in schools. And again, like the scripture says, man, let me read it again. You gotta know who you're dealing with. And this is who we're dealing with. Lest there be any fornicator or profane person as Esau. You know, he's a natural fornicator. You know, he's a natural freak by nature, man. Nothing is foul in Esau. You know, nothing is ungodly to Esau. But the truth, you know, he's a freak, man. He's a nasty motherfucker, man. You know? In school, I mentioned before in school. White boys talking about the next best thing, the closest you can get to a woman's pussy is a shit. The fuck do you know that shit? And where the hell you get that shit from? Closest thing you can get to a woman's vagina is a sheep. These motherfuckers is out in rural America fucking sheep donkeys. And that's a custom that the Norman tribe picked up as well. Over in the islands and shit. Cuba, Venezuela. The specialist on what you call Vice News. Dude went over to islands, I can't remember what island it was. But it was normal that before a girl met a dude, she knew even had a relationship with a donkey. Because the custom back then, the young boys, to break their virginity, they those little fucking donkeys, right? The dude was walking around random places, and he was seeing the distance. A boy or a grown man already popping a donkey, popping a fucking donkey, man. Oh. Absolutely incredible. Just absolutely incredible. You know? So Esau, a man who prostitutes his body to another lust behind, a man prostitutes, a man who indulges in unlawful sexual intercourse and fornicate. You know, so he wanna push this will on you. But the scriptures clearly say,
the Lord thy power giveth thee, thou shalt not learn to do after the abominations of those nations. There shall not be found among thee anyone that maketh his son or his daughter to pass through the fire, or that use divination, or in the words of the tongue, or a channel of wit, or a charmer, or a consorting with an express, or a visit, or a necromancer. All that do these things are an abomination unto the Lord our power. And because of these abominations, the Lord our power, thy power doth drive them out from before thee. Thou shalt be perfect in the Lord thy power. You may know the precept here. Romans 6 and 4. Now shall ye see in Babylon gods of silver and gold and of wood, borne upon shoulders, which cause the nations to fear. Beware therefore that ye in no wise be like to strangers. Let me read that again. Beware therefore that ye in no wise be like to strangers. Neither be ye afraid of them when ye see the multitude before them and behind them worshiping them. And say ye in your hearts, O Lord, we must worship thee. For my angel is with you, and I myself can for your soul. Right? Give me another one here. these are the statutes and judgments which ye shall observe to thee in the land, which the Lord thy power of thy father has given thee to possess it all the days that we live upon the earth. You shall utterly destroy all the places wherein the nations which ye shall possess serve their gods, upon the high mountains and upon the hills and upon every green tree. This one to the history of our people. You know, it's beautiful how he again, how he sent the message to the prophets and the prophet to share amongst the people, in this case Moses, right? And ye shall overthrow their altars and break their pillars and burn their groves with fire, and ye shall hew down the graven images of their gods and destroy the names of them out of that place. Ye shall not do so unto the Lord your power, but unto the place which the Lord your power shall choose out of all your tribes to put his name there, even unto his habitation shall be sent from hither, thou shalt come. And thither he shall bring